Hi everyone, welcome to Cal and welcome to the Letters in Science Computer Science information session. I'm John Canny, I'm the current division chair for computer science. I'm going to talk a little bit about computer science and electrical engineering at Berkeley, and then I'm going to hand off to John DeNero, who's one of our outstanding teaching professors in computer science, and he'll give you more information about the program, and also he's an inspiring guy to listen to. So, next slide. So first of all, a sincere welcome to University of California, Berkeley. This is one of the great educational institutions on earth, the greatest public university on earth. Virtually every one of its departments is in the top 10 in the country, and including electrical engineering, certainly, and computer science, but also practically every other discipline. It's a full liberal arts, science, engineering school. And so you really have an opportunity while you're here to experience a unique educational experience from the point of view of breadth. And we hope that you take advantage of that. So to give you a little bit of an overview of the department, our mission is to create knowledge through research. And we have a great amount of depth and experimental expertise for doing that. But we also have an interdisciplinary focus. And we'll talk about that both within the department and also to some of the other excellent departments on campus. So most of the faculty have an interdisciplinary focus, and that allows us to sort of push the boundaries of knowledge in new ways. We're also focused on educating future leaders, including in academia, government, in industry, and those who like to take risks and do startup companies. There's great facilities for all of those kind of activities within the department. For academia, we allow undergraduate students to participate in research with grad students and faculty. And we have a number of entrepreneurship offerings within the College of Engineering that can take you through the full process of starting up a company and getting funding and so on. An important feature of Berkeley, important part of the DNA of the university, is social responsibility. So our third mission is serving society. And, you know, there are many programs within engineering and within the campus as a whole that do that. And I'll just call out one, which is the Center for Human Compatible Artificial Intelligence. And that was started up recently by three Berkeley professors, Stuart Russell on the left, Anka Dragan in the middle, and Peter Abeel on the right. So the Center for Human Compatible AI looks at both the opportunities of AI, but also some of the risks of very powerful intelligent machines and some of the social impacts that those devices can have. And Stuart Russell recently completed a book. It's called Human Compatible: Artificial Intelligence and the Problem of Control. And it's one of the very important works on the potential risks from artificial intelligence. Right. So in terms of national reputation, our program is among the top in both electrical engineering and computer science. At the undergraduate level, Berkeley Electrical Engineering is number two. Computer science is ranked number four most recently. In terms of engineering overall, it's at number three. And in terms of graduate programs, electrical engineering is at number two right now and computer science at number one. And those numbers, certainly for the grad program, has been true for most of the last decade. And so we have a very successful faculty. They've garnered a number of awards. A particular note of the National Science Awards, these are the really highest level awards in science. And they've been awarded both to John Winery in electrical engineering, also Richard Karp in computer science. National Medal of Technology and Innovation, which is a national sort of technology award, went to Chen Ming Hu. The ACM Turing Award, which is like the Nobel Prize for computer science, has had six Berkeley winners, most recently David Patterson. IEEE Medal of Honor has gone to a number of our faculty, including Chen Ming Hu again. And the MacArthur Fellowship or MacArthur Genius Award went to two of our current faculty, Claire Tomlin and Dawn Song. And then a number of other rewards. I won't list all of these, but I'm sure you get the idea. The faculty have national stature and have been repeatedly recognized as leaders in their fields. And Berkeley faculty are particularly active in writing textbooks as well. There's nearly 70 textbooks in computer science that have been written by Berkeley faculty. Perhaps two of the best known ones are the Artificial Intelligence book by Peter Norvig and Stuart Russell, which is the most widely used textbook in AI. And also the Computer Architecture book by David Patterson and John Hennessy, also probably the most widely used textbook in computer architecture, and many others. So there's a very good chance that you'll be using one or more of these in your undergraduate studies. So the EECS department at Berkeley, there's around 100 faculty and also a number of active alumni, emeritus faculty, about 30 of them. And we also have some professors in residence. They're focused on research, and adjunct professors who often do additional teaching. And our graduate program is quite large. We have around 550 PhD students and about 200 Master of Engineering students. And that's a separate program that you can take without a Berkeley degree. We also have a fifth-year master's degree for bachelor's students to continue on. And that's an option for you at the end of your four-year program. The undergraduate program is really the big one. It's by far the largest undergraduate computer science program in the country. And both halves of our computer science students are, both programs are actually, would probably individually be among the largest in the country. So we have about 1,750 in Letters in Science, Computer Science, and about 1,600 in the College of Engineering. So the EECS majors are getting an EECS degree, and that degree isn't differentiated among Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. It's a combined degree. But it is true that most of the students in this program are oriented more towards computer science. So if you count overall number of computer science majors at Berkeley, it's probably around 3,000. All right, and where is EECS? We're in several buildings. Most of electrical engineering is in Corey Hall, which unfortunately you can't visit this time. But it's a somewhat attractive building on the north side of campus. And across the street is Soda Hall, which is computer science. So electrical engineering, including some of the classrooms that you'll likely be in, is in Corey Hall, along with the electrical engineering faculty. Computer science faculty are mostly in Soda Hall over the right side here. And a number of classrooms are in there as well. And the other space that you'll hopefully experience in your undergraduate program is Jacobs Hall, which is right next to Soda, actually. And this is a remarkable maker space / teaching studio. So it's almost all classrooms, and the classrooms are in a studio style, so benches and prototyping machines. And those classes will allow you to explore your design inclinations and your creativity, and mostly in team projects. And actually, you can also get a maker pass and use the maker spaces in here at your own leisure. So those three buildings are the main buildings that you'll experience in your undergraduate program. If you do some research, you may also be in some of these other buildings where there are additional EECS faculty and graduate students. First of all, Sataja Dai Hall, which houses the Citrus Activity Center for IT Research in the Interest of Society. That includes a lot of microelectronics and some AI and a few other disciplines. And it's adjacent to Corey Hall. It's a little bit, this bridge actually joins Sataja Dai to Corey. The other big space is Berkeley Way West, which is about 10 minutes walk away from the other buildings in downtown Berkeley. And that currently houses the AI research activity, most of it. And then finally, there's the Simons Institute, which is focused on computer theory. And that's in Calvin Lab, this interesting circular building, roughly in the, southeastern end of campus. And that houses some theoretical computer science and also a variety of short-term programs focused on particular topics. Yeah, and they have some interesting interdisciplinary programs now, including artificial intelligence, social impacts of AI, AI and the law. And so, yeah, so that's an interesting possibility if you, again, if you have some ability to do research while you're at Berkeley. So the last thing I'll mention is the interdisciplinary DNA within electrical engineering and computer science. So both EE and CS have traditional areas. So for electrical engineering, there's areas like physical electronics and microelectronics and signal processing that are part of core of EE. And similarly, in computer science, we have areas like databases and programming systems that are part of the core. But there's also a big interdisciplinary middle that includes areas like security, communications and networking, artificial intelligence and robotics really fit in the middle here. So both the faculty that teach your classes and the classes themselves quite often will span this middle between EE and CS. So with that, I'm going to hand off now to John DeNero, who will tell you more about the program. And once again, welcome to Berkeley.